ceremony of the Paralympic Games is now with us here. How quickly it has come around. This is very much a festival. The festival of the flame. We will witness the flame going out at the appropriate time in the closing tonight. It's been an absolutely magnificent number of days leading up to this spectacle. After what seemed like only yesterday, where we viewed the spectacle of the opening ceremony. An absolute sellout, of course, for tonight's spectacle. Talking to Sue Malcolm earlier on this evening, one of our volunteers here at the International Paralympic Committee was saying it's very much based on a pagan. She's a professor at the UCL, a graduate from Oxford. Volunteers have done an absolutely splendid job here across all venues throughout the Olympic Park.
9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
So here we have part number one of the running order, wind storm this evening. The Festival of Flame pays tribute to the gatherings that infuse the spirit of our nation. we'll be reminded about the irresistible power of music to draw us together, as it does at world-renowned festivals up and down the UK. From Kinross, Belfast, and the Brecon Beacons, to Glastonbury and the Isle of Wight, festivals occur all over the world when people and communities come together as one to enjoy the best of human entertainment and creativity. During the pre-show, the athletes took their places in seating areas around the field of play and are part of the ceremony from the outset. There are three circular stages here, and at one end of the stadium stand the agitos, the symbol of the Paralympics. Three crescents are made of giant inflatables that have been tethered to the ground. They've been tethered to the ground by a group of characters called the Dreamers, who are all asleep. Hornblowers signal the wind is coming, and the Dreamers wake up from their sleep to protect the agitos. Huge fans were mounted on motorbikes ridden by the wind gremlins. They appeared in the stadium bringing noise and wind with them. The Dreamers battled against the might of the wind to prevent the agitos from being blown away. As the storm escalates, the agitos are lost and fly into the night sky alone with one of the Dreamers, who gets blown away with them. All the sound of the wind, horns and chants increases. The wind shows no sign of calming, and a storm is on its way. A huge smoke cloud appears at the end of the stadium. And 68 performers entered carrying flares. They're followed by 54 drummers who process into position. The Dreamers represent our dreams, ideas, passion, and goals. The wind gremlins represent our internal demons, who dampen our spirit and put out the fires inside us.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome into the stadium His Royal Highness the Earl of Wessex, patron of the British Paralympic Association, and the President of the International Paralympic Committee, Sir Philip Craven.
So moving on to raising of the flag in moments to come. I'm now joined here in the commentary box by Katrina Webb. Good evening, Katrina.
Good evening. How are you
Ladies
going?
And gentlemen,
I'm good, thank you. And how are you?
I'm going fantastic. Can, it's very exciting,
stand
this ceremony.
For the national anthem of the United Kingdom.
That was Lisa Hermans, who is blind and autistic, and she sang the national anthem from the Sundial stage. She made history when she became the first person ever to release the national anthem as a single to mark the Queen's Diamond Jubilee this year.
Unlike the other ceremonies of the Games, the 4,200 athletes are seated before the ceremony begins. They are seated in and around the field of play, putting them at the very heart of the action here.
This is Rory Mackenzie, who has walked to the top of the steps of the Sundial stage and is about to address the crowd. Through Help for the Heroes, Rory Mackenzie has been able to indulge his passion for extreme sports, including skiing.
You're all wondering about the meaning of agitos. Simply means I move in Latin.
My friends,
they are to the Paralympic Games what the rings are to the Olympics.
Every country, welcome to the last night of the Paralympics here in London. Festivals occur in every culture, in every corner of the planet. They are, and have always been, auspicious occasions. Gatherings of peoples and communities are coming together as one. Tonight, we bring you the Festival of the Flame, the symbol of the spirit of the Games, which has burnt bright here at London 2012. Tonight, we celebrate that spirit, and although we have many differences, There is one quality we all share, one thing all of us have in common: human spirit. We have all been touched by the triumphs and drama of the Paralympics, witness to the heroic spirit of the athletes. We have come together in peace for the Games, and through that respect for each other, we have found hope for the future. Let the love that the Paralympics has kindled in our hearts burn brightly as we come together as one for the Festival of the Flame.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the flags of all athletes.
That was a great moment for Rory Mackenzie. He lost his leg on patrol due to a roadside bomb, but is able to walk again following treatment at the Headley Court.
So here come all of the flag bearers now into the stadium.
164 nations and athletes that you can see there who have had exceptional performances throughout the Games.
164 nations across 11 days, 503 medal events across 20 venues and 20 sports.
I did meet Elisa Delana from Fiji the other night, and he's the only athlete from Fiji, so he got the great honour of carrying the flag into the stadium and also carrying the flag in his closing ceremony.
Happy man. Super. So there we can see from this aerial shot all of the athletes, 4,200 of them there, centre of the field of play,
who have captured our hearts and minds over the past 11 days. As we said, 164 nations, 11 days, 503 medal events, 20 different venues and 20 sports. And Nick, it looks like they're making some kind of shape here with the flags as they walk out into the middle of the Olympic Stadium.
And I wonder what shape that may be. I've got a good guess.
Yeah. I think if you think of all the emotions that we've been through over the last 11 days, and the great British people have really, really genuinely got behind the Paralympic movement, and let's see what this shape is, but I have a feeling I can feel what it might be too.
Something to do with party performances, I think.
That's right. And I think all these Paralympians have touched the hearts of many people worldwide. David Weir, I can see sitting in the middle of the screen. Managed to finish the marathon today, fourth gold medal, and carrying the flag there.
And there, yeah, we both say it together. There we can see the heart.
That's right. I think this is amazing. I really like this moment of bringing the flags in and representing the heart of the last 11 days. And it looks like the fire's burning. Fire's burning in the shape of the heart. I think maybe to leave a stamp in that stadium to say that we've been here over the last 11 days and here is something to remember us of.
Having worked at the Olympic Games and the Paralympic Games, the enormity and scale of success of these events here across 20 sports has been something else. Many have quoted the Olympics being a warm-up for these Paralympic Games. Having been to many venues, the roar from the crowds and the fans has been quite deafening. And here are the flags of the athletes are formally welcomed. Deafening support across all the venues, from all the fans, from all over the world. 164 countries here in London 2012, 18 more countries than ever before.
I call upon the spirit of autumn, the spirit of water, of the ebb and flow of emotion, of open seas and running streams, of cleansing rain, spirit of the evening sun, of twilight and of autumn. I call upon the spirit of winter, the spirit of earth, the womb of creation, of night and the snows of winter, deep roots and ancient stones. I call upon the spirit of spring, the spirit of air, the breath of life, of sunrise, and of new life and new growth. I call upon the spirit of summer, the spirit of fire, of energy and of passion, the spirit of the noonday sun, the heat of summer, vitality and abundance. My friends, let the festival commence.
Thirteen sections to this festival this evening. Festival of the Flame. Very much the spirit of the Games has been noted, and we move now into autumn.
I was just thinking there, Nick, how well Rory did. I wonder how many times he practiced that verse in his lounge room. And how do you prepare for a moment like that when you know you're in front of the world and you don't want to be nervous, you don't want to make a mistake, and he did an almighty job.
Yeah, nobody wants to make a mistake. I was nervous just sitting here before moments of countdown. That man stood in front of the middle of 84,000 people. Adrenaline pumping through his veins, I'm sure. And that keeps you on your edge. He's doing a grand job.
You know, and he's probably pinching himself thinking, you know, he lost his leg on patrol and now has this incredible moment in life. And that's what I love about the Paralympic Games is all of those 4,200 athletes have a story. Something happened in their life that completely changed. And all of them having this wonderful experience at the London 2012 Paralympic Games, I'm sure many of them will be thanking the world for that moment that changed their lives, because this is something extraordinary that they've experienced over the last 11 days.
Well, I'm sure of that, convinced of that. And Katrina, of course, you've got a story to tell. You're a multi-gold medalist winner yourself. Four gold medals, is that right, across three different Paralympic Games. So what memories does this bring back for you?
Extraordinary memories. I watched three closing ceremonies. I participated in three opening. In fact, I got to bring the torch into the stadium for the Sydney opening ceremony in my home country. And this closing is a party for the athletes where all of their hard work is done. This has been a build-up the nerves, the stress. And when you get to this moment, you say, ha-ha, we did it. And particularly when you ran a PB or you got the result you set out to achieve, this is their moment to just say, we're going to party and enjoy this ceremony.
To the seasons that were described a moment ago, this section is simply called Truck Invasion.
Now, Nick, there are five big trucks loaded with casts of characters coming in, and 20 smaller vehicles and a cast of 90, creating a very fantastic atmosphere, the festival atmosphere. Some of these vehicles were featured in the film at the beginning of the ceremony. Collection of weird and wonderful vehicles and machines with exotic sounding names and strange moving parts.
Strange moving creatures as well.
Don't they look extraordinary? I love them. It's a little bit like Edward Scissorhands mixed with and a gorgeous looking fish to the top left of the screen.
Well, we were all told yesterday at the debrief that it would be a tremendously artistic closing ceremony, and it's certainly that already, just a few minutes in.
So that looks like the steampunk steamship, which rides on a billowing cloud of sailcloth, driven by a little girl called Kitty. You can see all the athletes there with their cameras, their iPhones, whatever they can to be taking in all of this action.
So we've seen a Clamposaurus, a helicopter, the beast from the earth, the bug, the time machine, and the car that had to be towed through this section.
And the music also is called Truck Invasion, is a new composition by David Arnold based on Coldplay's Politic from 2002. Guess what all these are, Nick, from what you've just described.
I'm desperately trying.
What would this one be? Maybe the bug?
The bug made from an ex-wartime British Army truck with wings formed from moulds of submarine nose cones.
This one looked like the Golden Cloths truck made of whirling, turning cogs and wheels.
Could well be the bug right there, Katrina.
Well, that could be the helicopter, retired Royal Navy helicopter transformed into a whale with elegant motorised wings from an industrial fan and a cheeky aircraft tail. Maybe you as the viewers can decide as we enjoy this ceremony together.
To be towed, if we can spot that, was created from two VW Beetles.
spot the steamship. It's driven, as I mentioned before, by 10-year-old Kitty Castledine, who's an aspiring actress. Following a viral infection 2 years ago, she now uses a wheelchair. Fantastic moment for young Kitty.
Helicopter is a retired Royal Navy helicopter transformed into a whale. With elegant motorised wings from an industrial fan and a cheeky aircraft tail.
What a great truck invasion that was.
May the songs of the earth and of her people ring true. Hail to the festival of the flame, of root and branch, tooth and claw, fur and feathers, of earth and sea and sky. Ladies and gentlemen, I introduce to you our wonderful Paralympic athletes.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Wang Yun Dai Achievement Award to honor the triumph of human spirit.
For the past 12 days, the best athletes from around the world have come together here in London in an exceptional demonstration of mind, body and spirit. Six nominees have been selected for the Wang Yun Dai Achievement Award, and two will be awarded to those who best exemplify the spirit of the Paralympians. Dr. Wang was stricken with polio at the age of 3, but through strong will and determination, she overcame that to become the first female physician with a disability in Korea. Dr. Wang dedicated her life to the development of Paralympic sports in Korea and around the world. At the 1988 Games in Seoul, the Wang Yun Dai Achievement Award was established to enhance the will of people to overcome their disabilities through sport. The Paralympic Games is not just about winning medals or beating other athletes. Even though we fall sometimes, the Paralympic Games gives us the power to overcome. The Wang Yun Dai Achievement Award is to honor the athletes who see beyond their limitation and have the vision to change the world through sports and Paralympic Games. For London 2012, the award goes to Mary Nakamicha Sakayo. Mary has been a Paralympian since 1992. She believes the Paralympics empowered her to change her life, and her achievements have also inspired the lives of many others, especially in Africa. Michael McKillop. Michael is the winner of 3 gold medals for Ireland. He endeavors to empower the younger generation through his success. He believes the Paralympics have the power to change the lives of others.
To present the award to the winners, Dr. Wang Yun Dai and Mr. Greg Harton, Vice President of the International Paralympic Committee. Michael McKillop, Athletics, Ireland. Michael has demonstrated his exceptional quality in sport and Paralympic Games.
What an incredible moment for both of these athletes.
Can't quite believe it, can he? Very emotional deep inside there.
Athletics,
Ireland have had a very good Paralympic Games.
Mary has a vision to change social perception towards people with disabilities in African countries with her sporting career.
And Nick, these are the ones you don't expect as an athlete. You know, you go out there to do your best to try and win gold medals, but when you get recognised with awards like this, unbelievable moment.
It is about the recognition as well, so important that this should be the case. Mary Zakeo, Athletics Kenya.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the newly elected members of the International Paralympic Committee and its Athletes Council.
So six newly elected members of the IPC's Athletics Council will come onto stage right now.
The IPC's Athletics Council represent athletes within the Paralympic movement and uphold their rights and obligations.
Arnaud Assoumani, Athletics, France.
Just to let the viewers know that as these athletes were competing, they had to get votes in the village, in the dining hall.
Gizem Girisman, Para Archery, Turkey.
So they put their name up and then they, just like you want to be elected to government, or they do the same
John
thing.
John McCulloch, football, seven
aside.
Let's
not forget, it's a big dining hall. Thousands of competitors there eating and voting
that's
at the
right,
same time.
That's right.
Teresa Perares, swimming, Spain.
And they don't have to be current athletes. Some of the athletes are, of course, retired. So they come and campaign during the games.
Elvira Stinnison, sitting volleyball, the Netherlands. Yu Chu Yi, wheelchair fencing, Hong Kong, China.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the representatives of the volunteers for London 2012.
Now I can hear the roar in the stadium because the volunteers here at these games were so amazing. And without volunteers, Paralympic Games wouldn't exist. Over 70,000 volunteers in total over the period of time. And
always smiling.
Always
so
smiling.
So helpful to every individual that needed support. Guidance and support from themselves, absolutely second to none, working very, very long hours, well into the night.
The newly elected members of the International Paralympic Committee and its Athletes Council will present a gift of appreciation to the volunteer representatives of London 2012 to thank them for their contribution.
Really like that. That's a great idea to have the athletes giving wonderful hugs there. It is so special that the volunteers, over 70,000 over the Olympic and Paralympic
Ladies
Games.
Ladies and gentlemen, the volunteers of London 2012.
Six athletes from six individual sports. And I must say, I had the joy of commentating live for all of the events that Teresa Perales swam for Spain. Teresa Perales there on stage.
Do you know there was more than 240,000 applications received for people to volunteer to be game makers at the London 2012 Games, and 100,000 people were interviewed, and then 70,000 got the job. And this is the moment I've been waiting for. In fact, if viewers know this band, this is Coldplay.
And you were there for the rehearsals today.
I was.
Lift off this blindfold, let me see again, and bring back the water, let your ships roll in my heart she left the hole. And the tightrope that I'm walking just sways and ties, the devil as he's talking with those angels. angel's eyes. And I just wanna be there when the lightning strikes and the saints go marching in. And sing slow it down through chaos as it swirls. It's us against the world. Like a river to a raindrop, I lost a friend. My drunken has a Daniel in a lion's den. And tonight I know it all has to begin again. So whatever you do, don't let go. And if we could float away and fly up to the surface and just start again and lift off before trouble just erodes us in the rain. Just erodes us in the rain. Just erodes us since he rouses in the rain. Send slow.
Coldplay here on the central sundial stage as they introduce this section of the closing ceremony. Autumn is with us.
Coldplay have said being asked to play at the Paralympic closing ceremony in our hometown is a huge honour. We can't actually imagine a bigger honour. This will be the biggest night of our lives.
Through chaos as it swirls. It's us against the world.
So their number one single, Yellow, from Centre Stage. Here, says lead vocalist Chris Martin. It's where we all record, rehearse and live. These games have been a chance to show London off to the rest of the world and for us to watch loads of table tennis. That's what he said.
Now this is Ken Doko Dance Company. It's a contemporary dance company of disabled and non-disabled dancers. They're a charitable organisation. They are a source of inspiration, support and innovation. And I must apologise if I start singing because I love Coldplay and I love this song.
Yellow is one of my favourites, absolutely right up there. On top of my stack, I must say, at home.
And it was all yellow. Oh. Your skin, oh yeah, skin bones turning to something beautiful. So
yellow is being performed here. A specially created flame dance features 12 members of the Kondoko and 12 flame dancers.
It's rising from the center of the stage and bursting into flames.
Listen to the crowd, that was yellow. We had up against the world first of all. We'll now move into up in flames.
This is the Coldplay concert tonight. And as you said, I did see them in the dress rehearsal. And yes, so they're live and sound just as good as their recorded music does. This
time I have to ask, did you meet them and speak to them individually? Were you that lucky?
No, I wasn't.
Why not?
I wish. You tasted it. Now we have aerial artist Dennis Remney and Lindsay Kerr, who has cerebral palsy. Lindsay was a member of a group of disabled performers who spent 8 weeks training at Circus Space, learning circus, aerial and other performance skills.
Slowly gone up in flames.
disabled parties, music care, and together they perform a beautiful aerial ballet above Coldplay right there. Oh, we have slow.
You know, we've seen athletes sweating all week, 11 days, and it's great to see the lead singer of Coldplay showing us how hard he works in his particular profession. But I must admit, today was about 28 degrees in London. It was a beautiful day, and it's perfect weather tonight for this closing ceremony.
Often an Indian summer, as we call it, here in England, and we certainly have had that. The weather has been perfect across all 20 sports. Paradise next for Coldplay. 19 fireflies descend from the roof.
If you're a Coldplay fan, you would know that four of these five songs have come from Milo Zaloto album, their 2011 album, and maybe if you're not, there's a chance you might download it now. Great supporters of the Paralympic movement. When she was just a girl,
she expected. There are the fireflies. The balls and the fireflies start to pulse, and people on the ground begin to spin them. Pyro is used here to maximise the effect as the fireflies signifying the end of autumn.
I think our Paralympic athletes have dazzled mankind over the last 11 days, haven't they?
Those who are dead are not dead, they're just living in my head.
So we're now into winter.
Since I fell for that spell, I am living there as well. Oh, time is so short, and I'm sure there must be something more. Those who are dead are not dead, they're just living. Those who are dead are not dead, they're just living in my head.
Ooh. Now that is the Snow Queen, Victoria Modesta, 24-year-old lower leg amputee, model and singer-songwriter. And as I mentioned, she was the Snow Queen.
Thank you. I've got to say I'm on my way down. God, give me style, give me grace, and put a smile upon my face. And put a smile upon my face. And put a smile upon my face.
That's Laszlo Sinnott and Lindsay Adams, motorcycle aerialist. He's one of the most skillful high wire artists in the world and has toured the world and performed at many prestigious venues, including Cirque du Soleil, La Nuba. Now, Lindsay had her left leg amputated above the knee in August 2010. Yeah.
Matt Fraser on the drums, who was born with short arms. He's a musician, an actor and performance artist. He's been a professional drummer for over 25 years and was approached by Chris Martin about performing with Coldplay this evening. What a night for him.
To spring now, and you may have seen the grasshopper truck come alive and 12 acrobats leaping from the centre of the grasshopper into a giant butterfly.
Some 120 children ran through the audience and headed towards the fish truck. They all carried parts of the fish truck skin and scales.
I can't hear.
They attach those parts through the truck as Coldplay sang.
Cheers.
fish is now alive as the net rises around the fish. The car kits decorate the truck to its full glory and give it its life.
Make some noise! Make some noise!
Charlie Brown by Coldplay. Some 120 children, 600 car hubcaps. They decorated an old East German army truck rescued from the scrap pile of the Cold War and debris washed up on the shores of the Devon coastline.
Stadium is teeming with life and spring is truly here. And someone very special will be revealed on stage very soon. Steamship truck and a very big celebrity is on board. Steamship truck travels round the track, followed by a procession of large flags.
Somebody ran away, saying fast as I can. I've got to go. I've got to go. Once upon a time we fell apart. You're holding in your hands the two halves of your heart. Oh, oh. I am.
So nice. Rihanna. Rihanna performing with Coldplay.
Have to go on the water on my flame. Could have been a princess.
Since her debut in 2005, Rihanna has won an astonishing 5 American Music Awards, 18 Billboard Music Awards, 2 Brits and 5 Grammys. She has sold more than 25 million albums and 60 million singles. This year, she was named one of the most influential people in the world by Time magazine.
Being at the Paralympics is the biggest honour, Rihanna says. These athletes are gladiators and a true inspiration to me.
Thank you.
That was Strawberry Swing with the British Para Orchestra, which was released in 2009. Now, the British Para Orchestra are composed of 17 performers with disabilities, including a one-handed pianist and an electronic musician with such severe cerebral palsy that she requires 24-hour care.
When I rule the world, Thank you so much, everybody.
Viva la vida there with aerialist Denis Demnev performing with six maypoles and eight carousel creatures. They took to the air signifying the celebration
of summer. Please stand for the Paralympic anthem performed by the British Para Orchestra.
Now we have the Paralympic anthem performed by the British Para Orchestra.
Paralympic flag is lowered by a team of three members of the Ministry of Defence. Sergeant Allen, Gunsman Baldrillo, and Flight Lieutenant Stedham.
This is the Paralympic flag handover ceremony. We'll see the flag be taken to the Mayor of London, Boris Johnson, It'll be then passed to the president of the International Paralympic Committee, Philip Craven, who entrusts it to the mayor of Rio de Janeiro, Eduardo Paes. The Paralympic Anthem by the Para Orchestra.
Please welcome the President of the International Paralympic Committee, Sir Philip Craven, accompanied by the Mayor of London, Boris Johnson, and the Mayor of Rio de Janeiro, Eduardo Paes, for the Paralympic flag handover ceremony.
So the Mayor of London, Boris Johnson.
The Mayor of London will hand the Paralympic flag to the International Paralympic Committee President, who will then entrust it to the Mayor of Rio de Janeiro, the host city of the next Paralympic Games.
And there's the Mayor of London, Boris Johnson, handing it to the President of the International Paralympic Committee, Sir Philip Craven. Who is now entrusting it to the Mayor of Rio de Janeiro, Eduardo Paes.
Ladies and gentlemen, as is customary for those who came, please stand for the National Anthem of Brazil.
Raised by a team of three members of the Ministry of Defence, Chief Petty Officer Grove, Corporal Lana, and Flying Officer Price.
Brazilian national anthem, heard many a time throughout the last 11 days, and will sure be heard a lot more in Rio in 2016.
I'm sure it will be the most successful swimmer in the pool, Daniel Dias, not just from Brazil, but from all swimmers across 75 nations. Brazil having a tremendous Paralympic Games here in London 2012.
This is Rio 2016's segment called Joy. If there is a national vocation in Brazil, it is joy. Joy has no prejudice. It does not choose colour, religion, skills, or social position. Joy is the property of all and each Brazilian. It is stronger than anything. joy unites and strengthens us. Now, Nick, this show will be divided into six parts, three dance battles and three musical performances.
The Rio 2016 artistic segment alternates musical performances by Brazilian pop stars with playful dance battles by groups who include disabled and non-disabled dancers in a playful, joyful celebration.
And this is Carlinhos Brown. Carlinhos is a musician and producer and is one of the most creative and innovative artists in the Brazilian music scene. He's released seven albums, the last one of which is Mixturada Brasilia. He was nominated for the 2012 Academy Awards for the original song of the film, Rio. Second battle. Carlinhos is not sure what's going on. He's fading into the background as our next second battle comes on. Parafuso versus Frevo. Palamas do Successor, Brazilian rock band formed in Rio in the late 1970s.
Italiana cozinhando feijão e americana se cantou com Pelé. A candace de mangaba, choque canela preta. Cachaça negra e gamo dando a volta no planeta. Caboclo presidente trazendo a sua missão. Livre pra comida, prato pra educação. Antes de baile, repara. Olha como ela samba, olha como ela brilha. Olha que maravilha!
Third battle, Capoeira versus Samba na Ponta. The third and last dance battle here between Capoeira and Classical Ballet.
interesting is that these ballet dancers are the only professional ballet company for visually impaired people in the world. They're accompanied by Roberta Marquez, internationally renowned Brazilian ballet dancer. And this colourful lady is Thelma de Freitas. A Brazilian actress, singer, songwriter, record producer, and dancer. So that's the end of the three battles, and into a wonderful party to finish off Rio 2016's segment. A taste of what we may see and experience in Rio in 4 years' time.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the chairman of the organising committee of the London 2012 Olympic and Paralympic Games, Sebastian Coe, and the president of the International Paralympic Committee, Sir Philip Craven.
Your Royal Highness, Sir Philip, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, together these past few weeks we've shared some wonderful days, haven't we? Days where incredible people have performed feats we hardly thought possible. Days in these Paralympic Games when our minds were open to what people can do, to what they can achieve by sheer talent and determination. And I want to share with you two stories from these days. Everyone will have their own tales to tell, but these are mine. I was traveling on the tube when I met someone wearing the familiar purple uniform and a pass marked medic. A games maker. And the games makers stand among the heroes of London 2012. We began talking. His name was Andrew, and he told me he was a doctor at St. Mary's Hospital on his way to helping out at boxing. But when I tried to thank him, he wouldn't let me. He said he was the one who wanted to do the thanking. And as we did a very British dance over who should thank who, he suddenly cut through all the politeness and said, "I was on duty on 7/7, that awful day. For me, this is closure. I wasn't sure. He told me I wasn't sure I should come or whether I could face it. I'm so glad I did, for I've seen the worst of mankind, and now I've seen the best of mankind. Just a few days later, I met Emily, a games maker at the Paralympic Games. She talked of what the games meant for her and what participating in wheelchair basketball means to her. It has lifted the cloud of limitations, she said. So, Andrew and Emily, I'm going to have the last word. Thank you. Thank you to you and all the volunteers. The Paralympic Games has set new records every day. Sporting records, records for crowds, for television audiences, for unbridled spirit. In this country, we will never think of sport the same way, and we will never think of disability the same way. And Emily, yes, the Paralympians have lifted the cloud of limitation. Finally, there are some famous words you can find stamped on the bottom of a product. Words that, when you read them, you know, mean high quality, mean skill, mean creativity. We've stamped those words on the Olympic and Paralympic Games of London 2012. London 2012, made in Britain. Sir Philip.
Thanks, Seb. Your Royal Highness, athletes, officials, games makers, distinguished guests, Paralympic sports fans from all over the world, these have been quite simply amazing Paralympic Games. Four years ago, the Beijing Paralympic Games closing ceremony's theme was a letter to the future. That letter was received with open arms by SEBCO's London Games Organizing Committee, who had over 100 staff in the Chinese capital committed to delivering successful Paralympics in London. What they breathed in Beijing left them smitten and determined to deliver an event that would feed the British public's insatiable appetite for elite sport. By building a giant theme park for sport in East London, designed to attract the world's best athletes, the Olympic Delivery Authority and LOCOG have helped inspire a generation. These were not just London's games, but thanks to Charles Allen's Nations and Regions group at LOCOG, those of the entire United Kingdom. Buoyed by the medal success of a host nation, this country has enjoyed a real feel-good factor like never before. There have been multiple examples of teams working closely together, LOCOG interacting seamlessly with the International Paralympic Committee, and similarly with the Mayor's Office, Transport for London, the City of London, the Security Services, and both central and local governments. But with those irrepressible smiles and fountains of knowledge, the biggest cheer, it's already happened, but it's going to happen again, the biggest cheer of London 2012 should be reserved for now as we say thank you again to the thousands of games makers. Similarly, thanks to all international and national technical officials and classifiers. And now let us also acknowledge another band of people that stepped into the breach and went far beyond the call of duty. The British Armed Services and the Emergency Services. The compact and excellent Paralympic Village became home from home and launched 4,250 athletes into orbits of achievement which had no limits. Paralympians, you gave to the world feats of speed, endurance, dexterity and skill many did not think possible. You led the world's media to wax lyrical over your performances and left millions of Paralympic sports fans to create what Boris Johnson said to me last week, a wall of noise in the venues, hungry and desperate for more. The Paralympic Games have truly come home and found their pathway to the future here in London. The Paralympic spirit, which saw its first sparks of life in Stoke Mandeville some 64 years ago, has followed a supercharged and surreal existence over the last 12 days. This has made the London 2012 Paralympic Games unique. And without doubt, in my mind, and those of the athletes, the greatest Paralympic Games ever. I call on you all gathered here and watching around the world to take this unique sporting spirit to all four corners of planet Earth, where you will make new friends, have fun, and inspire them to light the flame in their hearts. This is an event absolutely no one wants to end. We know that. And these games have changed us all forever. But before I close, I want to link Stephen Hawking's words about changing perceptions across multiple dimensions from the ethereal opening ceremony to the words of a five-year-old called George Glenn. A few days ago, George was reading a book entitled Treasure with his mum, Emma, my daughter Gael's best friend. The first page showed a man with an eye patch, a hook for a hand, a parrot on his shoulder, and a wooden leg. Emma asked George who the man was, expecting him to say a pirate. But he said, he only has one leg. He must be an athlete. Kids just get it. Now, thanks to the amazing performances we've seen here, we all do. Finally, the time has come for me to declare the London 2012 Paralympic Games closed. But we all know that these Paralympic Games will live on for an eternity. I call upon Paralympic athletes from all over the world to meet in Rio de Janeiro in 4 years' time, where once again you will inspire and excite the world with your sporting excellence. And I have to end with a big, big thank you to the people of this great city of London. To the entire population of the United Kingdom. Thank you.
So to summarise the speech there of Sir Philip Craven, President of the International Paralympic Committee, an amazing Paralympic Games, fueling elite sport. It was inspirational, had an unprecedented feel-good factor across speed, endurance, dexterity and skill, presenting and giving a wall of noise and a pathway to the future, the greatest Paralympic Games ever.
Now to extinguish the flame. Johnny Peacock and Ellie Simmons. They both take the flame to show that the flame will continue to burn on for the next 4 years in the lead up to Rio 2012. It's 2016.
You just don't want the year to end.
No, I don't.
So track gold medalists here. Swimming gold medalists here. Ellie Simmons, one of the most successful female swimmers in the Aquatic Centre, defending her title successfully. 17 years of age now, the youngest competitor, just 13 years of age, 4 years ago. And she will certainly be around in Rio, if not beyond.
Flames there symbolising the internal nature of the flame living on among each and every one of us.
I'm
Jay-Z and Rihanna on stage as the flames we shared amongst the cast.
And that was Run This Town, performed by Coldplay featuring Jay-Z and Rihanna. The second single from Jay-Z's album, The Blueprint 3. The original version features Rihanna and Kanye West.
How y'all feeling tonight, London? We reach it.
And Jay-Z leaves the stage. Coldplay.
Thank you so much, everybody. Before we play the second to last song, we've been asked, and it's our honour to say, please could you give a round of applause with us for all of the incredible athletes around on the pitch and people who've already left to go home. It's been unbelievable to watch you all perform, and it's such an honour to perform in front of you. So thank you so much. Okay.
Coldplay giving this remarkable evening here in the Olympic Stadium. Coldplay now will perform The Scientist on the Sundial stage. Our sporting highlights of the past 11 days will play on the large screens around the stadium.
Come up to meet you. Tell you I'm sorry. You don't know how lovely you are. I had to find you to tell you I need you. Tell you I set you apart. Tell me your secrets and ask me your questions. Oh, let's go back to the start. Running in circles or coming on tails. Heads on a silence apart. Nobody said it was easy. Oh, it's such a shame for us to part. Nobody said it was easy. No one ever said it would be so hard. I'm going back to the start.
How fitting from Coldplay. No one said it was easy, as we saw the dramatic pictures, live pictures that were brought to you
across
11 days,
experience in Great Britain,
made by Dave Cheeseman, the production director here at Paralympic Sports TV, PSTV. He was stressed indeed. He wanted those pictures to be perfect, and they certainly were, and shared with us all the remarkable moments that these athletes have shown and given us across this Paralympic Games London 2012.
Thank you, Jay. Thank you, Ray.
The last song by Coldplay. Every teardrop
goodbye
is a waterfall.
From London. I turned the music up and I got my records up. I shut the world outside until the lights come on. Maybe the streets are light, maybe the trees are gone. But I feel my heart start beating to my favorite song. All the kids, they dance, all the kids all night. Until Monday morning, seems another life. Turn the music up, I'm on a roll this time. And Rio is inside. I got my records on. From underneath the rubble, sing a rebel song. Don't wanna see another generation drop. Just wanna feel another generation reach the top. Maybe I'm in the black, maybe I'm on my knees. I'm in the gap between the two trapezes. My heart is beating, my pulse is starved. Cathedrals in my heart as we sing. I swear you emerge blinking into to tell me it's alright as we sing.
Can see that was the British band Coldplay. Chris Martin, the lead vocalist, Johnny Buckland, lead guitar, Guy Berryman, bass, and Will Champion on the drums. how incredible they were. They loved every moment of that. I even saw the Agitos single in Chris Martin's jeans. That final segment, we saw release of fountains of water from the stage to symbolise the final extinguishing of the Paralympic flame.
And here are the fireworks. Throughout history, fire has been seen as a symbol of beginnings and ends. As this celebration comes now very close to the end of a remarkable festival here, the Festival of the Flame. We have seen an extraordinary celebration of the journey that began 7 years ago when London was announced as the host city for the Olympic and Paralympic Games. It comes to a joyous and spectacular end tonight.
We also have fireworks along the river, which are part of the Mare of Thames Festival, which will lead up to the fabulous Paralympic logo, the Agitos, which means I move in Latin, that I've admired very much this week, that hangs on the Tower Bridge.
In a nation that's famous for festivals, from harvest festivals to music, comedy and film festivals, we've long enjoyed the shared experience of coming together to give thanks, celebrate creativity and look forward to the pleasures that lie ahead.
What a way to finish London 2012 Paralympic Games. And there it is, the Agitos, the Paralympic logo, that hangs from the beautiful Tower Bridge in London.
The three most popular colours decorate on all the country's flags around the world.
And that last image is a projection of the Houses of Parliament. Thank you, London. Thank you, UK.
To the athletes of the world, to the people of London and the United Kingdom, to the volunteers and the staff of the London 2012 Organising Committee, thank you for an unforgettable summer.
And thank you for inspiring a generation.
Good night and goodbye.
And that's the end of the closing ceremony. Thank you for inspiring a generation, they just said, as the spectators, the athletes, will now leave the stadium. I'm sure we'll enjoy a big party in the City of London.
I'm sure they will, Katrina. The night is still young for lots of people right there, right now. It really has been a splendid evening here in the Olympic Stadium. Full to the rafters, 84,000 people, all run to absolute time, tick-tock timing here. And everybody has really enjoyed a splendid evening. I couldn't have been more delighted to see Coldplay there, one of the world's most best-selling music artists and acts. It was a great act tonight, a great concert. This, the Festival of Flame, has drawn to a close as everybody departs into the night skies. And there's one of the final aerial views we will see. A wonderful, wonderful festival of closure here in London 2012. From me, Nick Gillingham, do have a very, very good night.
Thank you very much, Katrina Webb. It's been a pleasure to be on the show tonight.